What's the clock say?
2:59.
What are we running?
Running the upper section this morning.
I'm out of carrots today.
Whenever I go to like proving grounds or test trips or something, I tend to just like buy a bag of carrots. So we do have sugar snap peas.
Anyone would dream of being on a closed mountain road, able to drive as fast as you can. You know, rolling up to the start line, you just switch on this other part of your brain. The noise of the world disappears, and you just focus on that task at hand. It's hard to describe why someone does it. It's like, why go to the moon? It's there, it's waiting for you, it's beckoning. As a driver, it's a similar thing. Pikes Peak International Hill Climb is the second oldest race in North America. I think the first running was in 1916. It's point to point. You have a start line and a finish line. You try to set the fastest time you can between those two gates. I have a time in my head, but I'm not going to say it.
While the race cars make slightly faster time, it is the stock car class that catches the fancy of most motorists. These cars are the very same standard models anybody may buy readily.
It's a really unique race because you're starting at 9,000 something feet and you're ending at 14,115 feet. It's just you taking the green flag and the mountain.
There's skids and spills aplenty on the 165 curves and torturous turns that dot the way up the 14,000 foot course.
And it is dangerous. If you have a split second lapse in judgment, you're not going into a wall, you're falling off a cliff into rocks.
There's practically no margin for error.
The saying is on race day that the mountain decides. I'm a senior performance test engineer and test driver at Rivian. This year, I'm competing in the 2025 Rivian R1T quad motor. It's a whole new animal. It's hilariously fast. With 1,025 horsepower, we have our brand new Michelin Pilot Sport tire. We now have our in-house Rivian designed and built drive units, which have better cooling, better performance. This is a huge challenge for vehicles, so what better proving grounds to showcase the awesome potential of this platform? You know, the Gen 1 R1T is no slouch, so it's pretty wild how big of a performance difference the Gen 2 R1T is. You know, the first straightaway, I was hitting speeds that I couldn't imagine last year. Running this race isn't just a look how fast we can go, it's real world. Look how much better we can make your car. As a test driver, this has just been one big fancy test drive.
About like 118 to 120 yesterday going down into bottomless pit, which is a little bit spooky. I did have a really good run going and then got red flagged halfway through due to the incident in the middle section.
one of the competitors in the exhibition class with us had a mechanical issue with the vehicle and ended up running off and sort of hitting the guardrail and I think rolling over and maybe went down the mountain a little bit. The driver's okay, but sustained a broken leg. It shows like the risk versus reward here. And I mean, everyone just wants to see everyone else finish the race because we all know how difficult it is to do this in the first place. A bummer, but it's part of the game we're playing.
Today was unique. We only got one run in because of the poor weather. It was like totally foggy, raining, blowing sideways when we got there.
Wow.
The news was the winds at the summit were like 40 miles an hour. Race day could be like these conditions. And at the end of the day, it's like you gotta get to the top of the mountain and not wreck.
Like, I'm from the mountains. I grew up in the mountains. It still, like, still gets me.
It's race day, Sunday. It is just after 5 in the morning. It's pretty chilly up here, but it's clear skies.
The electric production truck Gardner Nichols set that last year. He's going to try to best his own time of 11:23.983. So those are just the
ready? I'm ready.
All right, man. Have a good run today.
Thank you.
The Rivian gets heavy, but it is freaking fast.
He just lit the, I mean, that thing took off like a rocket.
When you launch, it's just, you're in this pure, like, state of focus. Like, you have to perform. All this practice leads up to, like, being able to do this dance with the car. Link corner to corner to corner, and just trying to be precise with everything. You just get in this, like, flow state of you and the machine and the mountain. And you can just focus on driving.
That's Gardner Nichols finishing his run up. Oh, drops a tire in the dirt there to hook that Rivian R1T around the corner. You see the bumps there as that car hops and skips over them. And coming across the stripe, Gardner Nichols chasing his own record. 11:23 was his time last season. Is it going to be faster than last year?
I got your time.
Wait, you have my time?
Yeah.
Say 10. 10:53. Fuck. I'm trying to break 11.
Break 11?
Yeah.
10:53.
Was that confirmed?
10:53.
Yeah, I'm pretty stoked on that. The historical significance of all this is always at the back of my mind. You know, we've learned so much more about the Gen 2 R1T that can help with future decisions, whether it's R2, R3, R3X, you know, making these the best cars that we possibly can. I think there will hopefully always be a place in Rivian's heart for this type of event.
Oh my gosh, is that Bigfoot?